What is going on, you guys? Demonic Ducky here, bringing you guys a long-awaited episode for the GM Mode. You guys have been asking me about this, and here it is. GM Mode finally back. I'm going to be recording more GM Modes more often now, so expect more of them. I was just taking the holidays off. Anyways, guys, we have a giant trade deadline right here. We are going to make a move. This is going to be a really hard move to make, though. Everybody said trade Carolina. But here's the problem. I really want to take the goalie from Carolina, because if you look in the stats for Carolina, they're doing amazing. They're having an amazing season right now. Probably a banner season. 34-25-4. But then when you go look at their stats for players wise, you're thinking they got this stud goalie who's going to be amazing in a few seasons. He's getting shutouts all around. This is what shocked me. He's not playing in the NHL. They have Eddie Lack and Cam Ward up in the NHL, tearing it up right now. Eddie Lack more than Cam Ward. But then when you go to their AHL team, this guy is 29-8 in the AHL. He's listed as a backup goalie. So they have no room for him right now. He's supposed to be in the NHL, but he's playing minutes in the AHL. We can solve this problem for them. Now, we can't give them Mike Smith. They're not going to want Mike Smith. Mike Smith is an older goalie and is going to have to be played in the NHL. Therefore, they already have Eddie Lack and Cam Ward. So we're going to have to trade them something else in order to get this goalie from them. Now, I'm looking at it. Maybe we can trade Mike Smith to another team for a draft pick, or we send Malcolm Subban back down to the AHL, which I don't think Malcolm Subban will be happy with that, because he is listed as a backup, I believe. Let me check real fast. All right, guys. Let the record show Malcolm Subban is, in fact, listed as a backup goalie, so we cannot send him to the AHL. That will not fly with him. That will just destroy his morale, and we just need to stop destroying player morale here. So Mike Smith is on the trade block. So we're going to have to deal Mike Smith to a team that wants him. Maybe after we get into Belichick, we're finding a team that wants him. Because I can throw Mike Smith up on the board right now. Like Mike Smith. Like Anaheim wants Mike Smith. Maybe we can get like maybe a third for him. Or obviously, I don't know why they would want Mike Smith. They already got Josh Gibson. John Gibson or whatever his name is. Yeah, this dude looks like he's doing amazing right now. I gotta see what his stats look like. Yeah, look at that. Look at those stats. Reflexes, almost all 90s or high 80s. That's crazy. Puck control is almost amazing. Same with athletic ability. Yeah, that's an amazing goalie. He's 33. Out of 54 games, he won 33 of them. Has a pretty good save, yeah, percentage. So maybe Mike Smith could go and maybe coach this young goaltender right here, because Mike Smith's got 1 year in his contract. Maybe he could help talk out with Gibson and get him going. Like, do we take a pick for him? I think we should. Maybe. See, they don't want any of their picks. That's perfect. Because I know a first pick's way too crazy. That's a little crazy right there. Maybe we take like a second pick. Yeah, second round. Maybe a second and a third. Would that be asking too much? Actually, I think that would go through right now. Oh, that's Malcolm Subban. Yeah, okay, that's why. That is why they want him. That's Malcolm Subban. I was wondering why Mike Smith's trade value is so high. Yeah, no, they want Mike Smith, but they don't have the cap for him. Would any team have the cap? Arizona wants Mike Smith. Maybe we bring Mike Smith back to Arizona for maybe a draft. They have Holpe, though. Like, they don't need him. Oh, they need a backup goalie, it looks like. But Mike Smith is listed as a starter. We really don't want to do this to Mike Smith. He brought us through the playoffs last year, even though we were eliminated first round. Mike Smith's a very good goalie for us. We don't want to just toss him out, but we're going to have to in order to make playoffs. Like, we can't. They're going to have more than 50, so we're going to have to take somebody back. Maybe take back somebody they don't want. I guess this Hill guy. someone who's not going to be anything, unless we take this guy they want to get rid of. I think that's the guy we traded them for, Mike Smith, I think. If I'm not mistaken, yeah, that's the guy we traded them for, Mike Smith. So do we bring Andre back to Florida and then deal him in another trade? We might have to. Because they want to get rid of him. They have no room for him. So maybe we do that. We'll take a second round pick. I don't know if that would go through. I mean, we can try it. That's going to free up a lot of cap. And then we can deal the second round pick in order to get this goalie we need. Is Mike Smith going back to Arizona? No. Okay, yeah, that's way too much value right there. Maybe a third. We just need to get Mike Smith out of here so we have enough room. Yeah, they don't have a third this year, so like a third next year. Oh, yeah, that will go through. Without a doubt, that's going to go through. Trade rejected. Oh, okay. Yeah, Mike Smith's too expensive. So they don't want to put a guy on waivers, so that's understandable. So Mike Smith's not going back there. Boston wants him. I mean, Boston wants to get rid of their pick. They have our first-round pick this year for us giving them Subban. They don't really have a third. We'll take a second. But we have to take a player back. This time of year is going to be hard to deal Mike Smith. Unless we deal Subban. I really don't want to deal Subban, though. Because we overpaid a lot for Subban, and I know that. But maybe it's the right thing to do. Alright, guys. I've been thinking this over. And unfortunately, after playing four long seasons with us, we're going to have no choice but to deal Malcolm Subban, unfortunately. Because I'm looking at this, because if we really want that goalie in Carolina, we're going to have to get rid of Subban. Because I'm looking at this, we got Viskanen coming up. He's already listed it. He still has a backup potential. Right now, he's a minor backup goalie. But in about two seasons, he's going to be our backup goalie for the NHL. And not to mention, we can make Mike Smith. We got Al Montoya back down there in the AHL. We just, Subban, I think we killed his potential. Like, he's been at an 85 overall for three long seasons now. I think it's time for him to move on to bigger and better teams that will maybe treat him better. Maybe he'll go to Carolina with Eddie Lack and Cam Ward, and they'll teach him stuff. He needs to be around a more successful team, not a team that is going to make playoffs like we are, but he could go to a team that's first seed in their division, such as Carolina is, because they're number one in the Metropolitan Division. So we give them Subban for Nebelichik right there. They don't want Subban, though. That's the problem. But Subban looks like he has a little bit higher trade value, so maybe if we throw in some picks there, take it. I'm hoping they will. Maybe if we throw in, I don't want to get rid of any picks for this year or the next year, because we've already dished that out. Maybe because I don't think we're gonna be going until 2024. I think we're done starting a new GM. Maybe a third. That's kind of close. I want this to be realistic, but Malcolm Subban's an excellent goalie. So what if we give them a third and a fifth and a sixth, like a sixth from this year and a fifth from next year, because that's not really losing anything. Yeah, that would go through. Is Nebelichok coming to Carolina and Malcolm Subban saying goodbye to his former team? Trade rejected. No, so they really do not want anybody here. But I do have an idea. What if we deal Malcolm Subban to a team that has a first round pick, like Anaheim? Because I'm pretty sure they'll take Subban for a first round pick. Yeah, without a doubt, that's going through. No, okay, so that's just a little off. They want us to sweeten it just a little bit more. So what if we give them a seventh round pick? Maybe that'll go through. Yeah, no. Okay. We're in a really weird tantrum right here. Alright, guys. I thought about it. And here's what we're going to have to do for the goalie. No team is going to take Mike Smith because of his cap. Him having 1 year left, we can keep Mike Smith for the rest of the season. Maybe throw him as a backup. In order to get this goalie we want, here's what we're going to have to do. Nebelichok is a really good goalie. I actually looked at Carolina's team, and there's one thing they're lacking, and that's defensive prospects. Now, our defense is really young, besides just a few people, but they're really replaceable. They're like 80 overalls. It's like our third line, and we only have one of them. So I'm thinking, what if we do this? This is hurting me, but we're gonna have to in order to get this goalie. We give them Nugent Hopkins. That right there is not hurting value or anything. I do not know if they want Nugent Hopkins. I don't think they need him. And then we will give them something they want. Like, you know, skaters match and block. Maybe we can find someone they want. That's not that really... Ooh, excuse me. That's not that important to them. Only person I can think about giving up is Drew Shore. But how's Drew Shore doing for us? That's my question. Yeah, I mean, he's fourth line. They really need someone on the fourth line, but so do we. Yeah, I'm not going to give them Drew Shore. I really don't, our offense is stacked. We could give him Joki Paakka. We just signed him. He's supposed to be a top six D-man. That's what he's supposed to be right now. He's on the third defensive line for us. So he, right now, is not getting the time he's supposed to. So we could actually dish them Joki Paakka. We'd have to take somebody back, so... What if we give him Joki Paakka, Malcolm Subban? I know Subban has had a great few years for us, but if you think about it, Mike Smith can be our backup goalie, and this Nebelichok guy, and then we got Viskanen coming up soon. So we're going to have to eventually deal Subban. I believe we did hurt Subban's potential. I know I overpaid a lot for Malcolm Subban, and maybe we'll take back someone they don't want. Who do they want to give away? Actually, they want to get rid of Cam Ward. What if we take Cam? We give them Mike Smith for some reason, odd reason. We make that trade. They have Cam. We have Cam as our backup. Like, we have Cam as our backup goalie. We give them Subban and maybe a first round pick. Like, would that go through? But then we have Mike. Then we have three goalies. We'd have to, instead of Subban, we give them Mike Smith. Like that, and then we would give them a first round pick from like 2024. I mean, I know I've given away almost every first round pick we've had, but this is like the only option we have if we really want this guy. A first round pick, and we give up, I really don't want to give up anything else, because this is already a huge loss for us. We're already getting rid of Mike Smith. We're losing Joki Paakka. That's fine, I can bring Nuge up to the NHL, which I'm glad that we're not getting rid of Nuge. He's not really ready to play in the NHL, but he almost is, so hopefully we can find somebody we can bring up. And we dish them a... I want this to be realistic, but it's really hard to make this realistic. Since we're not going to be going until 2024, hopefully, because, of course, the year we win the Cup, if I deem this a dynasty, I'll end it. So, two Stanley Cups in a row. Hopefully, we're winning this one and the next one. And then, so on, we'll go from there. Okay, a first and a second. Mike Smith and Joki Paakka for Cam Ward and Nebelichok. Is Nebelichok going to be our brand new franchise goalie we can build around? Accepted. Welcome to Florida, Nebelichok. That's a huge trade for us to help us in the playoffs. Now, here's what we need to decide. PK Subban, okay, we have to move somebody down. I already know this. We have to bring somebody up on defense. That's for sure. We're short of D-man. So, defense. Yeah, we're short of D-man. So, we're going to have to bring up Nuge. Yeah, we're going to have to bring... Unless we play Camper. I'm going to play Camper. Yeah, we're going to play Camper for sure. Because Nuge, yeah, there's really no room for us to bring anybody up. So we'll put Glance back down. He's got to go through waivers. Nobody's going to claim him, hopefully. Yeah, he went down just fine. I knew he was. And we'll play Camper. Camper will play the spot that Joki Paakka was in. And then goalie-wise, here's going to be the problem. We have three backup-listed goalies. That's gonna bite us in the butt. Right now, we could send down Nebelichok, because now he's 84, because he has he has really bad morale with his new team, and we let Malcolm Subban get the start for the playoffs and Cam Ward. Yeah, that's what we're going to do. I don't know, though, because he's listed as a backup. I say we can't send Cam Ward. That's a lot of cap to be sending to the AHL, though. We send Cam down. If somebody claims, we hope somebody claims him. If nobody claims him, he'll sit in the AHL for this season. Okay, nobody claimed him. We're letting him sit in the AHL for this season. He deserves ice time, though. So Cam Ward, depending, this is hard to decide. Like, who's gonna get what? Edit lines. I might just go best lines and see what they do. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go best lines and see what the assistant coach does. Of course, all of this is still the same. Lawson, no. I want Vincent Trocheck there because you're listed as a... Oh, now you're listed as a depth forward. Both of you are. I want Vincent Trocheck there because I think he has better faceoff. 77. 77, about the same. So I want Vincent Trocheck there because that's what's been working. Lawson, you're still a third. Riley Smith. Jonathan, no. Jonathan Huberdeau goes there because I want him to still. He's top six. He's still listed as a second liner. He's not first line yet. Brendan Perry, third line. Jimmy Hayes is listed as a second liner. Riley Smith is a third liner as well. Brendan Perry, that's a sniper. So, yeah, I want the sniper there so we can get more scoring out of this line. And then this will be more of a grindy line. Wow, Lawson's going to be. He's going to be at least an 88 next season if he keeps this up. That's going to be amazing. That's going to be sick having him on the left wing. And then him and Jonathan Huberdeau are going to... Hopefully Jonathan Huberdeau is an 88 next season so I can play him on the wing. And then... Because I believe he will be at like 89 max. And I'll start playing him on the wing. Taylor Hall is still growing. That's sick. So is Nick Bjugstad. Nick Bjugstad is going to be... His max... I think he's going to max out about a 90. But that's still going to be really sick. Alright, and now defense-wise, who did it? Yeah, they have Camper playing. So yeah, that's just what I want. Camper's there. Uyghur, Gudbranson, Kyle Quincy, Kolenkoff, and Ekblad. And then goalies, who do they have playing? They're Belichok and Subban, so yeah, that's still the same. Am I sure about that? Yeah, it's still the same. So they want Belichok to get the starts. Even though he's listed as a backup. So I guess we just swap him and Subban out. I guess that's fine. And then down in the AHL for defense, yeah, you still get the Nuge there. Al Montoya and Viskin. Oh, okay, so they're not giving Cam Ward any starts. Maybe we can deal away Cam Ward for like a pick or two. Like maybe we deal him away for just a few picks. That way he still gets good time on the ice because he still deserves time on the ice. I got to fix this again. Jimmy Hayes, you're a... But you're not a backup goal. You're second line. So you'll be there. Huberdale's going there. Brendan Perry's going there. Alright, that's the way I want everything to look. Alright. That went very well. Alright, now we're going to take Cam Ward. And we're going to deal him for a pick. I don't know. Maybe we can get a third out of him. Because Cam Ward... Yeah, he's really mad he got sent down. I understand why. So maybe he's listed as a backup. Carolina wants him. That's weird. We're not going to do that, though. We want this to be realistic. Maybe Calgary. Does Calgary really need a backup goalie? No, he's not going to get any ice time there. Chicago need a backup goalie? No. Colorado? I want him to go where he will get played. I want teams to play him. We're looking for a team that really wants him as well. We don't want to just, here in New Jersey, take him. No. We want him to go to a team that wants him, that's going to welcome him into the NHL to where he'll have a backup job. Because I know he's probably going to retire this season. I do not want him to retire at Florida Panther because he's not going to play a single game as a Panther. So we might as well send him to a team that's going to let him retire with a backup goalie job. I'm not seeing anybody. Okay, now it's saying nobody wants him. That's odd. I guess we send him to Calgary. Like, saying nobody wants him anymore. Okay, now it's saying they want him. Alright, Calgary. So we'll send you Cam. We'll send you Cam Ward over for a. They're gonna have more than 50 players, though. I have a feeling. Oh, you have Washington Capitals, but that's way too much value for Cam Ward. Yeah, it's we're gonna have to get like a. We're gonna take somebody back. So give us a fourth. And give us someone who's unsigned. Give us. You gotta have a rookie skater that's unsigned, right? Someone who's unsigned. Wow, you guys really don't have anybody that's unsigned? You gotta be kidding me, right? Oh, there we go. Alright. Oh, why don't we take this guy? He's a defensive prospect, low end. He's a really low end defensive prospect, but. 68 overall. When we bring Nuge up in about a season or two, he could take Nuge's spot down in the AHL. Castengay? Right now he's playing in the CHL, so that's no problem. So he's not much of a cap hit for sure. Yeah, he's not much of a cap hit at all. I think that's a decent trade. Yeah, I think that would go through. Trade rejected. Alright, we'll just take the fourth off. That'll go through. No, they don't want to get rid of him. Obviously, I'm not thinking here. We'll take Devin. We'll just take someone we can throw in the AHL. We have to take someone who they have signed. We need a D-man for the AHL is what we need. So we can find a D-man to take for the AHL, maybe? Damper, your potential is too high. We'll take you, and maybe I'm going to try to squeeze a fourth out of this. Can I squeeze a fourth out of this? That's kind of close. What about a fifth? I'll try to squeeze a fifth round pick out of it. No, okay, so just that. Okay, they don't want to take on the excessive cap. Yeah, that's 5 mil. We're retaining about a mil. I didn't realize that's what it's saying. I should really read those when they pop up. We'll take a mil. Actually, we'll take a mil 0.5 because I actually want that guy who's in the CHL now. I actually want that prospect in the CHL. So we'll go ahead and we'll take the prospect they have in the CHL for Cam Ward, and we'll retain that much space for them. Where'd he go? We'll take him. Oh yeah, that's definitely gonna go through. Yeah, okay, we have to take a little bit more. It's fine, Cam Ward has 1 year left. We'll hold 50%. We don't really need cap right this second. We don't need cap right now. Okay, so we got a defensive prospect that we can play in the AHL next year when we try to bring Nuge up if he's ready. And therefore, there we go. So that's our team now. So we got two backup goalies playing starting goalie right now in the NHL. That might hurt us in the playoffs. I don't think it will. I think we can still win a cup this year. If not, we're definitely win one next year. All right, let's go to player morale, and then we're going to get this season over with. This is probably a long video right now, but it's okay. Malcolm Subban, it's confusing why you've decided to get another player with the same role as me. A little competition never hurt anybody. No effect. All right, I'm not happy when you choose to trade away Mike Smith. It really changes the locker room for me. It was a hard decision. I'm sorry it affected you that way. That's true. No effect. Glad to join the team. I'll make sure this trade looks good for you. I'm sure you will. Welcome aboard. I think that was a trade that will leave both teams happy. I believe that. Positive effect. Nice. All right. So the morale is down because we just traded away Mike Smith. He brought us deep into the playoffs last season. I understand why everybody would be disgruntled that we traded away Mike Smith. But it's fine. So let's get this season on the way. Hopefully Nebelicek plays good. I'm pretty sure I'm saying his name wrong. But by next episode, I'll have his name down. Oh, nice. We can give him the start against Carolina coming up. That would be a great game. We have to slow Simnet. We're definitely going to give him the start against Carolina. And we lose 3-2 first game. Let me make sure he's in net. I really want him to start against Carolina. Edit lines. Is he in net? That'd be great if he is. Goalies. I'm sorry, Subban, but we have to start Nebelichok for this one. I want him to play against his old team. Kemper has something to say. It's not playing. Not playing is easier. I'm ready to go, and I'm happy to be back in the lineup. I hope you take this chance you've been given and run with it. There is very little room for error. That is true, because I think you're on a contract year as well. No effect. Because we have that prospect in the CHL now. So, alright. So, we got this game against Carolina. We're starting this guy against his old team that didn't play him in the NHL. Hopefully, he shows his old team, because his old team is a powerhouse that they should have played him in the NHL. End of the first period. Oh, okay. So, they get one on us. Reed scores on Nebelichok. Nebelichek. Nebelovic. Oh, I gotta think I would say his name. As I said, I'll just look it up. Alright, and the second period, Santarelli gets one on him. That's not good. So, come on, guys. It's up 2-0. Wow, they are completely destroying us. 32 shots to 9. They are a good team this year. They really are. Wow, their defense must be shut down. We need more shots. So, it's not the goalie's fault. He's actually having a really good night. Only 2 goals on 33 shots. Power play killed off. Big kill. Let me go times 8. Big kill and Nathan Gerby. I'm going to slim the rest of the game 5-0. 47 shots to 13. That wasn't our goalie's fault we lost that. That was a lot of shots. That was all Carolina being a good team. All right, as always, we're slow sim to Tampa Bay games because those are big games of slow sim. Wow, we're on a losing streak here. We got to get it together. Yeah, we haven't won a game since the trade. Come on, guys. Okay, we lose one more. I'm going to have to stop Sim. And yeah, okay. We won one. Depending on this one, I'll see if I'm swapping up lines or whatever. Ryan Kessler, what do you have to say? I'm glad you are taking my obvious talents into account with excessive ice time I'm getting. There's a lot of guys in the locker room working hard, so earn some of your ice time. I'll say that. Hopefully we're not too hard on him. No effect. That's what I figured. Alright. Let me go put Subban back in net. Stop simulation. Stop. I'm going to put Subban back in net. That might be why we're losing games. Maybe Nebelichok's in net. We gave him some starts and he's not doing well. Okay, no. Subban's in net. Let me do this just to make sure. Alright. They're both 85s now. That's good. Our locker room chemistry is still 81, so we still have ridiculously high locker room chemistry, in my opinion. Hopefully, this trade is not going to affect our playoffs. Oh, it looks like it could. We're losing a lot of games here. All right, slow sim against Tampa Bay. All right, and the first period, Mike Weegar gets one. That's what I'm talking about. And the second period, all right, that's not good. It's a tie game. Anybody's game. Come on, guys. Let's take it. We're taking more shots. Ah, Palat gets one. Ah, Point gets one. That's not good. We're losing 3-1. Come on, guys. Come back. We got to win this game. Prove to me that this trade was not horrible. Come on. Come on, guys. Win us the game. Come on. 1 minute left. Get one more. And Brian Coburn's got to put the thorn in the side, and that's going to end that one 4-1. Come on, guys. Why are we falling apart here? We've been a playoff team every year since Bobby Lou went out. Are we not going to make playoffs this year? We have to make playoffs this year. Come on, guys. Come on. We got Buffalo. We beat Buffalo. All right. Not really saying much, but we beat somebody. Come on. There we go. I want to hit 50 wins. If we can hit 50 wins, we're good. I don't know if we have that many more games left. Just please make sure we're a playoff team. That's all I'm asking. Go to player morale. I want us to be a really deep playoff team. Jonathan Huberdeau is saying something. I have to admit, walking into that locker room makes me feel happier. That's good. Locker room leads to good things on ice. It makes us happy to hear that. Positive effect. That's good. Hopefully, I don't know if it's our scoring or if it's our goaltending. I'm hoping it's not our goaltending. But then again, I'm hoping it's not our lack of goal scoring either. Okay, end the first period, nothing. And the second period, Nick Bjugstad. Let's go. Come on. Here we go, guys. Hold down the fort here. We got to get one on these guys. Aaron Ekblad. There we go. There's my franchise player showing up for me. Come on, guys. Come on, third line. I'm looking at you. Get another one. Come on, Lawson. Well, I know you're not on the power play. I got to do the power play and everything like that. I got to check, see who's back on it. It's been a while since I've even looked at the power play. All right, we beat them 2-0. Who got the shutout? Was it Subban? The Belichick. There we go. He gets a big shutout against our rival, our division rival, and our in-state rival. All right, come on. Beat Ottawa. That way I know for sure we're up in the conference. We lose to Ottawa 4-1. They're probably a nice team right about now. We lose to Detroit. Come on. We can't be losing these conference games, guys. Oh, come on. 3 losses in a row. Why are we doing bad? Let me check to see if we're... Oh, we're on the outside looking in. We're in the wild card right now. We're very close to not making it. We need to win the rest of these games, guys. How close are we in the wild card? Let me look in the Eastern Conference. Oh, my. Oh, come on. Don't do the speed glitch on me. Eastern Conference. All right. We are number 8. That's not good, guys. Points. Oh, this isn't good at all. We're in a tight race. We need to win these playoffs. If we don't win the playoffs, that was a huge waste of time, that trade was. I know he's going to progress and everything, but that trade was to make us a contender in these playoffs. Right now, we're not a contender. We're a wild card team. We need to win the rest of these games. If we lose one game, our playoff opportunity could be gone. Come on. We have to beat Tampa Bay here. I know that for sure. If we don't beat Tampa Bay, guys, we're going to be in big, big trouble. Come on. We got 2 games left. We have to win both these games. Oh, I hope we have some games in hand. I should have looked at that. Here we go. In the first period, Aaron Ekblad and Riley Smith. Thank you. But Nikita Kucherov fired first, but it doesn't matter because we got some goals back. In the second period, wow. Wow. No, Subban, no. This is what I don't like about Malcolm Subban. One game he does amazing. He will get shutouts and everything. And then he lets in 5 goals. We need a huge comeback. Stamkos, Palat, Riley Smith, Ryan Callahan, and Strawman all got goals in that period. Come on. We need this win, guys, more than anything. This could be our season right here. If we lose this game, this could be the end of the season for us. Come on, if we need this win, though. Come on, 5-on-4. There we go, Taylor Hall get one. There's our captain coming to play. Come on, keep it up. One more goal. There we go, Erica Branson. Come on, keep it going. Get one more. Come on, we need this win. Don't let them get a point. We need a win. Come on, guys. All right, overtime. We got 1 point, but we need 2. We need to guarantee this wild card spot. Come on. Come on, we're going to the shootout. We're going to the shootout. And, oh, Jonathan Drouin in the shootout. Oh, come on. We need these points. Riley Smith with 3 points. Flipper with 3 points. And Nikita Kucherov with 2 points. All right. This is the very critical game. We have to beat Buffalo. If we can't beat Buffalo, we are not going to be in the playoffs. Are we even in the wild card spot right now? Alright, yes, we still are. Hopefully, Washington lost. Who lost? We don't have to worry about Ottawa. Okay, so Ottawa's a team we don't have to worry about. Who do we have to worry about? That's what I'm wondering. We have to worry about the Bruins? Oh, that's not very good for us. Oh, Washington won their game. Come on. This ain't good. There's only 2 wildcard spots. Pittsburgh's right there. Washington's right there. The Bruins are right there, too. We need the Bruins to lose their last game. This ain't good for us. Yeah, okay, so those are the teams. We need Pittsburgh to lose. We need Washington to lose. And we need the Bruins to lose. We need to make these playoffs. Taylor Hall is over a point for game player. That's amazing. All right, what am I doing? All right. Let's do this, guys. 1 game left. We need a huge win, and then we have to cross our fingers that everybody else falls apart. Not our team. Everybody else. All right. Come on. First period. Oh, come on. Don't make this a low scoring game. And the second period. Lawson cross. And Ryan Kessler gets one. But so does Baptiste or whatever his name is. Don't matter. Come on. Let's go. Times 8 simulation. Come on. Come on, Aaron Ekblad. I need you to score on the power play. No, come on. Somebody score on the power play. Our power play. We need one goal. Get us one goal so we can get this lead. Come on. We had a huge lead last game and we blew it. Vincent Trocheck right there making it a 3-1 game. Get one more. Come on, Taylor Hall. I want to see you go 86 points this season. You're not going to. But it doesn't matter because now, fingers crossed, our other teams in the race for that wild card spot messes up. Lawson with 2 points. Vincent Trocheck with two points. Malcolm Subban with an amazing night. Come on. Now we cross our fingers that we're in this playoff spot. Come on. Come on. Alright. I think we're in the playoffs. I really do. Because I just said I think we're qualifying for the playoffs. So we're going to go ahead and we're just scout. And we're scout the SHL for 6 weeks. No way to leave us alone. Alright, come on. We got the Flyers in the first round. Big that we made these playoffs. But I guarantee you we barely made these playoffs. Let me check the final standings. I know we barely made these playoffs. I feel it. We got lucky. Oh. Us and Pittsburgh. Oh, really? Carolina almost didn't make the playoffs as well. Carolina struggled after getting rid of Cam Ward. That's interesting. They were number one in the Neapolitan division back when we made that trade. Now they're number seven. Wow, so we're not the only team that dropped after that trade. So Washington, I'm glad we might have had a game or two on Washington. We had a point on them, so that's very good. So yeah, we made these playoffs. We sure did. We had about the same amount of points as Carolina, but I think Carolina had more wins than we did, so they would qualify. I guess I'm not sure how it works off the back of my head. I do know Pittsburgh was barely out there. Washington almost made it, but they had the exact same record. I guess Pittsburgh holds a tiebreaker over Washington. Yeah, it looks like they must. They have to. So that was a really, really close playoff race, but we thankfully made it into the playoffs. Let's see who took home the President's Trophy. The Edmonton Oilers, what a rebuild, took home the President's Trophy. All that hard work they've been doing, all that losing seasons has finally paid off. We're going to have a really hard time in the playoffs with these Philadelphia Flyers. I see it now. Taylor Hall finishing the season with 85 points. What a player. Point per game player. Over a point per game player. That's just sick. 38 goals. 47 assists. Excuse me. Nick Bjugstad. 27 goals. 51 assists. 78 points. That's what I'm talking about. That's what our big power forward we need on the first line. Riley Smith. He's getting third line minutes. Wow. 53 points on the third line. Ryan Kessler. 51 points. Actually, Riley Smith's on the third line. Because Brendan Perry's on the second line. Aaron Ekblad, 50 points, no surprise there. Jonathan Huberdale, 50 points. Brendan Perry, 48. Jimmy Hayes, 48. Vincent Trocheck, 33. Is that Lawson's? Is that a career year for Lawson? I think it is. Oh, wow, he matched last year perfectly. 16, 14. Wow. He was a minus 10 this year, but that's not going to bother him in about a year or two when he's our franchise player. Wow, that's like weird. He matched the years. Only difference is that year he's on the fourth line. This year he's on the third line. So, only 8 penalty minutes. That's awesome. That's great. So, yeah. He's going to be something. He's going to be great for us. I say next year he'll be a second liner. He's still listed as a third liner. Third line skater. So, I give it next year. Next year he'll be a really good player. Dmitry Kolenkov still doing really good for us. Goodrow, David Jones, wow, fourth line, getting 18 points, 10. So far, the only one without a point is Stephen Camper. But then again, he was our scratch player for all year until just now when we made that trade where we had to move, what was his name? It's like Yuri Paka or something like that. Yuri Paka, whatever his name was. Let's check out our attendees, and then I'll check for the full NHL, see who won what. All right, Subban obviously was with us all year. So 18-15 is his final record, and Belichick went 5-9 in the NHL. Hopefully, we didn't hurt him by playing him. He's listed as a backup, so he's ready to play in the NHL. Subban's still a backup. Hopefully, these two backup goalies can get us through the playoffs. If not, I'm sure one of their potentials will grow next year to be a starting goalie for sure. All right, now on to the entire league. Let's see who is the best goalie, and then let's see who had the most goals and points and blah, 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 blah. We're obviously not up there for anything. We could be up there for points for Taylor Hall, though. All right, most wins by a goalie, Ben Skriven's goals against average. Oh, God, that's horrible. 3.4. This guy, Calvin Pickard, or whatever his name was. Looks like he's been on the Avalanche for a while. That's shootouts. Goals against Hutchinson, but he barely played. Who had the best save percentage? Wow, you're horrible, Thomas Chris. Oh, that Pickard guy. Who had the most shutouts? Ben Skrivens. Oh, Mike Smith. Oh, that's nice to see. Mike Smith and Ben Skrivens. I really wish we could have kept Mike Smith somehow. I really do, but we just couldn't. Most shutouts. Then the Flower. Then Devin Dubnyk and Corey Schneider and the Hamburglar. Alright, did any goalies score any goals this year? Nope. Malcolm Subban's got 2 assists, though. That's awesome. Points for a goalie. Or Tau, though. Yeah. Alright, let's see. Let's see. Forward. Oh, you get all skaters. I'm dumb. Vladimir Tarasenko recorded 100 points, so that, I know right off the bat we're not winning anything for that. Yeah, 100 points. How about that? Tyler Seguin, 96. Jamie Benn, 88. Crosby, did I say Crosby? Ovi, 88. Crosby, 87. This guy, wow, this guy's a rookie and he scored 85 points? Are you kidding me? Really? He's an 87 overall. He's only 23 years old. Ivan Barbask? Wow, that's crazy. That's a great guy. Those St. Louis Blues must be a powerhouse. Taylor Hall, 85. Ryan Johansson. This guy. Corey Perry. Max Pacioretty. And Jonathan Tavares. All right, most goals this year was Vladimir Tarasenko. Oh, he one-upped Ovi. How about that? That's crazy if you can one-up Ovi like that. Most assist. Nicky Backstrom, this guy, Jamie Benn, that guy, 91 overall, wow, Yuri Hudler, David Darjan, I always have a problem with his name, Stevan Barkowski, whatever, TJ Oshie still putting points up, he's playing next to Ovi though, he only scored 14 goals. Alright, let's check out, what am I doing? Let's check out rookie skaters. Rookie skaters. Most points for a rookie skater. Probably that one guy. No, Ho Sang. This guy. Mitch Marner. No, Mitch Marner. He's finally in the NHL. DePreis. Daniel Sprong. Pavel Dzaka. Bergman. Milardo. Whatever. Matthew Barzal. Carter, who scored the most goals out of rookie scoring? There you go, Hosang. Most assists, Hosang, probably. Yep, Hosang, there you go. Rookie goalies. I think Nebelichok would be up there, too, because he didn't play that many games. Most wins for a rookie goalie. This guy, Billup, at 15-22, that's horrible. Most shutouts for a rookie goalie. Wrong one. There we go. Dance, 2 shutouts. Nebelichok had 1. That's great. All right, well, that's all for this episode, guys. Next episode will be the playoffs against the Philadelphia Flyers. That's when I'll hold the team meeting and do everything from there. If you guys enjoyed, please comment down below. If you guys have any ideas to improve this team, well, I said if you enjoyed, comment down below. If you have any idea to improve this team, comment down below. If you like the video, obviously, press that thumbs up button, and I will see you guys in the playoffs.